One, two, three.
My life is so exhausting.
It hurts.
Uh-oh.
I'm stuck in this bed. And I'm helpless. I can't go anywhere. I can't walk. The littlest things I can't do for myself. And the soreness I have in my body makes every movement difficult. It just hurts. My two daughters and five grandkids live with me, and I rely on my family for help. I feel a lot of guilt about how much my family have to take care of me. And it is so humiliating for my daughter to have to base me.
Taking care of my mom is exhausting. I don't want this to get any worse. But I wouldn't say I resent the things that I have to do for my mom, because you only get one mom, so.
One. We all have to help her.
Two.
Three. God, help me.
Ooh.
You got it?
I got it.
Oh!
My grandson don't even get a chance to be a kid because he's so busy catering to me.
Oh, Danielle, you just broke my skin. I felt it. Oh.
It really hurts me to see my mom struggle so much. It's hard to watch because she's in pain, but I have to do it.
This is the start of every day, and I hate it.
Okay, what you want to put on?
I'm so used to being in so much pain, I don't even know what to do. When I was 23, my dad got sick. He said, if you let them hook me up to this breathing machine, you're gonna have to be the one to sign to take me off. And that almost killed me. Nobody wants to see their father die. And after that, I started eating all the time and drinking more. Long as I stayed drunk, the feelings didn't hurt me. And my brother Eric was always at my house drinking and partying with me. One night, some guys outside my apartment was fighting. And my brother was shot and killed. My mom told me it was all my fault because I had him at my house. And to have your mom tell you that, my heart was broke in a million pieces. So I decided to leave town and move to Mississippi. And I met a guy, and we were happy at first, but over the years, things happened, he cheated. I grew unhappy and depressed. And during that time, I gained up to 445 pounds. And then in my early 40s, I found out my mom had cancer. So I moved back home with my mom. And she passed away shortly after. Losing my mom, almost lost my mind. I started eating around the clock. And I picked up weight so fast.
Lisa should be arriving any minute now. She's been in the ambulance over 6 hours, so we need to get her in and make sure no significant issue develop while she's been traveling.
Ouch, son of a...
Ow! Let's shift
toward that wall over where you talk past it, King.
Oh, God help me!
Feel like you moved?
Yeah, but you're trying to kill me.
Hi, Lisa. How are you doing?
All right.
Hey, doctor.
How are you holding up?
I'm in a lot of pain.
All right, let's get you inside so we can check you out, okay?
Thank you.
All right.
Lord, please, Jesus, don't let these people drop me.
Just a little bit. Don't be scared.
Oh, God, please. Oh, okay.
Lisa seems to be in a lot of pain and is clearly not happy about her situation. We need to see what's going on with her.
Oh, don't grab my leg, please. Oh.
1, 2, 3.
Ow!
Okay, Lisa, you're good.
I'm hurting so bad. This leg really bothers me.
Yeah, see all that lymphedema, and we will address that once we get your weight down. All right, let me come over there. We're going to do a quick weight check on you?
Yes, sir.
So, okay, you are at 704. That's very high. You thought you were at 642 when we talked, so you're a good bit off. And my concern is that if you stuck to the diet I send you, you should have easily been able to lose a good amount of weight.
I don't believe it's gained in weight.
You clearly didn't stick to the diet.
No.
You have not lost weight, and you're significantly overweight.
Okay, all I want to do is get clinked up. I'm not even going to fight you.
This is not up for debate. Even if all your tests come back okay today, you're gonna have to lose this weight because you're in a very dangerous situation right now.
I know.
Your body cannot continue on like this for much longer at all. So I'm admitting you to the hospital to start you on a 1,200 calorie controlled diet immediately.
Oh, man.
You need to take this seriously. If we don't get your weight down, you're going to die soon.
Oh, goodness.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
All right, we'll take care of you.
Thank you, doctor.
All right.
Oh, my God. Hi, babies.
Say hey, Gigi.
Oh, my God.
Y'all get her.
Give me some. Give me my sugar, girl. Oh, my goodness. I miss my babies.
I really came down here to find out what was going on and see if he was really losing some weight. Because sometimes I feel like you don't be telling me what I need to know.
I'm not gonna get the surgery I came here for. Dr. No is done with me.
So what are your plans going forward?
Well, I had just planned on just giving up Danielle.
Why?
I'm just not getting nothing accomplished.
And I feel like you're the only one of my children who even care enough about me.
You can't expect nobody else to be a cheerleader for you. You have to be your own cheerleader sometimes. You need to do it for yourself.
I know.
And you don't need to be letting me down.
But I can't let myself down either.
Right. We're gonna do this. Are you gonna do this?
Yes.
Got it.
I hear what Danielle's saying, but I spent a lifetime getting to this point. It's disappointing to not have weight loss surgery as an option now. But I'm gonna keep working at it. At the end of the day, I'm gonna have to do this the Lisa way.